Kari, thank you. Let's go now to Michael Genovese, who's in the US. Jenna, Joe Biden is in Poland, an important trip. What's he trying to achieve?
Charles, good morning. He's trying to show the world, and in particular Vladimir Putin, that Western allies right now stand united. Just moments ago, we saw Air Force One touching down in Warsaw. It's evening there, but the plan is tomorrow for Joe Biden to meet face-to-face with Ukrainians, some of the almost 3 million refugees who've had to flee their country, many of them women and children, as the men are forced to stay behind and fight, the majority of them in the Polish capital. Joe Biden spent yesterday at the Ukraine-Polish border, where alongside the Polish president, he was briefed on the humanitarian crisis, which, as you say, has been unfolding now for the past month. That's where he actually revealed that he wanted to cross the border into Ukraine to see firsthand what was going on there. But obviously, as a sitting US president, the security risk far too high.
Part of my disappointment is that I can't see it firsthand like I have in other places. They will not let me, understandably, I guess it, cross the border and take a look at what's going on in
Over the past 24 hours, we've seen the U.S. president near that Polish-Ukraine border, where he has been addressing and mingling with U.S. troops, men and women there. He was looking very relaxed, completely off script, as he thanked them for their service and explained that what was happening in Ukraine would have ripple effects felt all around the world. Now, this tour is set to continue tomorrow, where we will hear from Joe Biden. The White House is calling his address tomorrow significant, and the fact that it's coming from European soil makes it even more important. Charles.
Welcome back. As Russia cracks down on social media and independent radio and TV stations, it's easy to assume that misinformation about the war and the West is only just beginning to run rampant. But this is no short game. Russia has been feeding its citizens propaganda for more than a decade. Some say priming them for this very moment. Here to discuss this and more is Russian-American filmmaker Maxim Pozdorovkin. Maxim, you've directed several works on this topic. How warped are Russians' views on the West and on the truth?
Well, you know, I think one of the things is that when we talk about disinformation more generally, we often kind of talk about truth versus lies in these binaries. And I think that there's certainly plenty of lies in the Russian coverage, but there's also a lot of a kind of emotional framing. And what we've seen over the last decade is this framing of a kind of victim culture, that we're constantly under assault, that we're not being respected, that our interests aren't being respected. And a lot of the things that are happening now are being forced in, or rather the events on the ground in Ukraine are being forced into this narrative somehow. And, you know, statisticians and economists have a saying that goes, if you torture the data, it will confess. And the Kremlin has kind of a similar approach to facts.
Yeah, and in terms of this campaign, has it been successful so far?
Well, clearly not. And I think it's how successful can patching a leaky boat really be if there's constant holes in it. So I think it's failing, but it's failing slowly. But I think that what you see is that there's enough people. I mean, most of these people are bussed in and forced to attend. But there's enough kind of apathy or cynicism, and then there's enough people that do feel that resentment. You know, you only have to be successful with a small enough part of a population to be able to kind of fake broad enthusiasm when you control all the information channels.
And when there aren't the elections to get rid of people. When did this all begin?
I mean, it's hard to say. I mean, I think that in Putin's mind, I think that if you look at it kind of through a psychological prism, this is a kind of peaked pride issue. And the idea that I think a lot of people will say that around Afghanistan, that's where people will say that Putin had something like a true desire to help the West. I'm not sure if that's true anymore, but that used to be the narrative that would go. But from there, when a lot of the Russian kind of requests, I think, were ignored, he really kind of gave up on liberals, gave up on cooperation from the West, and started scheming, you know, and drawing to himself more of these kinds of imperial, grandiose, historical narratives, which he's now trying to implement. Hannah Arendt has this wonderful saying about that kind of tyrants tend to invent laws of history and then try to fulfill them. And what we see is something similar here.
I want to get to his comments about cancel culture in just a moment, but just to give us an idea, this is a propaganda, but not in the way we would have thought about it in World War II or World War I with leaflets and drops. What form does this propaganda take?
I mean, the Kremlin for a long time had a stake on basically television and cable television being basically free for Russian citizens, and then controlling which TV channels get to cover politics. So that was the way that a kind of mass consensus was guaranteed. Obviously, with each generation, as more people are transitioning to the internet, that became more and more difficult. So I think that that's been the primary give and take between in the kind of a Kremlin information. They've tried to spread out, but not as successfully. And you know, one of the reasons why they haven't closed YouTube yet in Russia, I think that's the last kind of major platform that remains, is because Kremlin propagandists also use YouTube. So it's so for them, shutting it down would be also losing a lot of that in that information sphere, where they're already losing the information war pretty drastically.
Well, as the war sort of slows into a stalemate, this is a really interesting and fascinating and crucial part of what's going on over there. We really appreciate your time this morning.
Absolutely.